All right, and let's talk another, perhaps a bit more advanced topic, but I think this is probably the most important one in this whole series, which is the notion of passing information by reference or passing information by value between different parts of my program, and what that means. All right, so let's talk about the problem. First of all, I have this example here that I've written. It's a console application that right now has three variables. It has an integer called number. It has an object of the type person. And for this, I'm using like a simplified example, a simplified version of the classes for people that I have written in my previous videos. So this one only has name and age, nothing else. No year of birth, no nothing, just like a very simple class. And in this other, I have another variable that is called X, and it's a complex number with real and imaginary parts. And this is the one that I have developed in my previous video. And with the only difference that this is, instead of being a class, is a struct, okay? But everything else is the exact same thing and it works exactly the same. All right, now let's imagine that I wanted to create some functionality in this program that takes any possible input and it increases the main value of that input by one unit. All right, so I'm going to write a bunch of functions that take different data types, and whenever they take them, they increase, they find what is the most meaningful data point inside of them, and they increase that number by one. All right, so how's that going to work? Okay, so let me start by creating a public function that lives in my program, and it's going to be called increase. All right, and then it's going to be a void function. It's going to return nothing. The only thing that it's going to do is it's going to take some data and it's going to make that data grow by one unit. Let's start, for example, with the person. So let me say that this function is going to be able to take any object of the type person. And then whenever it takes that object of the type person, it wants to go to the main data, numerical data point inside of it, and increase its value by one. How does that work? Well, what I can do is, in my function here, I can say, I'm going to take person, and I'm going to go to p.age, I'm going to take the value of the age, and I'm just going to increase it by one unit. Whatever it was before, I'm just going to crank it up. All right? And then, I forgot, this needs to be here, inside of the class. All right? So I'm going to see if this works. So I'm going to say, I want to increase the value of JL public static. You're right. I always forget about these things. Yes. So I'm going to increase the value of JL by one, and then I'm going to print to the console, I'm going to print the value of JL. So if I do this, all right, you can see that the object JL, let me print it before and let me print it after. So I'm going to print JL before and then I'm going to print it after. So, and you're going to see that the object JL before had an age of 100, then it was given to this function. This function took that object, cranked up the age by one unit, and now the object JL has one unit more on its age property, all right? So this feels natural, right? This feels like what it should be, because it's taken an object, it's changing it, and now that object has this new value, all right? So this that I just said is what is called passing an object by reference. Okay, and I will explain why that is the case. Because now let's take a look at a different example. Let's say that I were to, for example, write a method that takes, for example, public static void increase, and then this one is going to take an integer. All right, so it's going to take number, and then what it's going to do is it's going to say number needs to be increased by one unit. All right, so what I'm going to do is that now I'm going to say, I'm going to right line the value of number. Then I am going to increase the value of number. And then I'm going to print again the value of number. What I would expect probably is to have the value of 50 printed here and the value of 51 printed here, correct? Let's see if that's how it works. Oh, it doesn't work. I get the value of 50 both times, all right? Why is that the case? If that is the case, because here, this has been passed by value. I will explain what that means in a second, all right? And let me show you the last example. Let's say that I want to implement the same thing for the struct for complex numbers. So whenever I'm given a complex number, I'm going to increase its real part. So complex.real, I'm going to increase it by 1 unit, okay? And then I'm going to do the same example. I'm just going to copy paste this. This is x, I'm going to increase it, and I'm going to increase it. And then probably what you would expect is to say, oh, then the real part now before was 3, now it should be 4 in the second line. But it just so happens that this is before increasing it, and this is after increasing it, which means that this has not been increased at all. All right, so x has actually not changed, even though we have increased the real part here, because this is also being passed by value. All right, so what does that mean? All right, so it just so happens that the way computers work is that when you create a variable of any type, right, depending on what type of variable it is, they get stored in memory in different ways, but they also get exchanged between parts of your program in different ways. The way it works is that for primitive values, such as integers, doubles, booleans, and strings, I believe also strings, but I forget because those are treated differently depending on different programming languages. I believe strings are also passed by value, but I'm not entirely sure. Don't quote me on this one. When it's primitive values, what happens is that you have the value of the variable here. But when a primitive value gets sent to a different method or a different part of the program, or what it gets sent is the value that is represented by that variable. It's not the variable itself. So when, for example, when we execute this line of code here, what reaches num is actually just the value of 50, but it's not the variable number, so that when this is changed, the value of 51 is then stored in that variable, in that variable number in memory. That's not how it works. What we're sending here is a copy of the value that is stored inside of the variable. And therefore, because it's a copy of that variable, of that value, it doesn't affect the original variable that we had. So any changes that we make to number here inside of the function, it are not going to affect the original value that is actually stored in the variable number. Because this here, this variable number, the variable is passed by value, aka as a copy, and instead of passing the actual variable. The same principle applies with structs, all right? When we have a struct, because structs are a bit more lightweight objects, if you will, like I explained in my previous video, when we send x to this function here, what gets sent is not the x variable. What it gets sent is a copy of the x variable that is copied, let's say, on the fly, so that we can operate with that in the function. But because what is sent is a copy, then any changes to that copy do not affect the original one. So any changes that happen here in this method are not going to affect the original variable that was used and sent to this method. This technique is also, again, is called passing by value, because what gets sent is a copy that has no link, no reference, no backtracing to the original variable, and doesn't affect the original variable. However, with classes or with objects that are derived from classes, a different logic applies. When JL is sent to this method here, what gets sent is not a copy. What it gets sent, if you will, is like, imagine an arrow that is pointing to where this object is in memory. So a pointer, for example. What gets sent is a reference to where this person object, so where JL is in memory. So that inside of this method, we're not working with a copy of JL. We're actually working with the JL object in itself. Because what we got wasn't a copy. We got a reference to where that was living in memory. And therefore, any changes that we make here to the person object are actually affecting the original object that was sent into this method. And that's why this is called passing by reference. All right? So I'm not sure if you've ever encountered this situation where you were sending stuff to a function and you hoped that function to change that stuff, but that stuff was not being changed in your original code. That's because that stuff, which was probably primitive values or structs, that was being passed by reference. Whereas when you work with classes and with objects, objects are always passed by reference to methods. So any changes that you make to objects in a separate method will affect the original object. Okay? Now, please keep in mind, everything that I just explained is very, very C-sharp specific. The concept of passing by value and passing by reference exists in all programming languages. However, each programming language treats different types of data in different ways. The rules in C-sharp is that all primitive objects, integers, booleans, doubles, and I believe strings, but I forget, all right? That also changes between different programming languages. And all structs, they both always get passed by value, whereas classes and objects that are derived from classes, they always get passed by reference. So any changes that you make to the object in another method will affect the original object. And this is a behavior that you cannot customize. It's part of how the program works, how the programming language works. So if at some point you were working with an object and that you were sending to a method, and you don't want that object to change, you make sure that the code that you're writing in the method is not going to change the original object, or you make sure that what you change is, or you send to that method, is a manual copy that you have made from the object, so that if it changes in the method, it won't change your original copy. All right? There are a lot of advantages and disadvantages to both things, but once you know how things work, what gets passed by reference and what gets passed by value, it's actually quite helpful to have this distinction. It's very useful and it makes a lot of things much easier. Okay? So I hope that was clear. And I think we're ready to move on to the next video.